students, welcome to my channel PM Biology. Today we are going to learn about the very important pest of jawar plant, and the pest name, common name of this pest is jawar stem borer. Now let's have a look at the classification of this jawar stem borer. This jawar stem borer is belonging to the phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta. So these two will be common for all the insects. Then it belongs to an order Lepidoptera, because it is a moth, it belongs to the order Lepidoptera. Then family Pyralidae, and the genus and species name is Chilopartilus. And the other host plants are jawar, bajra, maize and sugarcane. Then look at the nature of damage of this pest. It is the most destructive pest of jawar and maize. The destructive or the damaging stage of this pest is caterpillar. It attacks all parts of the plants except the roots. The caterpillar attacks all parts of the plants and on leaves and ripening grains also. It, as a result of its attack, it remains stunted in growth and produce no grains. Means when this attack, when this pest attacks the plant remain stunted. Means growth doesn't occur in the plant and the grains are also very less or no grains are found on the plant or the crop. Then these plants show dead heart because of the complete feeding of this pest inside the or inner part of the stem of the plant. It becomes completely dead and the stage is called as dead heart. Then moving to the life cycle of this pest, as we know, there is complete type of metamorphosis because it belongs to an order Lepidoptera. So moth is the adult form, then the egg stage, and then larva or caterpillar stage, and then the pupal stage, which again develops into the moth. So this moth is yellowish brown color insect and it measures about 25 to 30 millimeters across the wings. So always remember, we have to measure the length of the wings across the wings, length of the insect across the wings, not in the height. Then it is straw colored wings are present. They have double row of black spots along its outer margin. So the wings are straw colored, means light yellow in color, and they have double row, two rows are present along the outer margins. So black spots are present in these outer margins of the wings. And in the hind wings, which are completely smoky in color in male, and whereas females, they have whitish colored hind wings. The tip of the abdomen is tufted with hairs in case of female, whereas this kind of tuft is absent in the males. So tuft of hair means bushy abdomen is there, and in case of the males, it is absent. Now the adult moth are nocturnal and they leave for 2 to 3 days, and further they oviposit for 1 to 3 days. Means during their lifespan of 2 to 3 days, they oviposit, and these eggs, they are laid on the lower surface of the leaf near the midrib, and these eggs are scale like yellowish eggs, and these are laid in the clusters. Egg hatches into the caterpillar within 3 to 5 days. So this is how the life cycle of Chilopartilus is there. Now you can see here the egg batch, because it is laying, the adult moth lay eggs in clusters. So eggs are laid in clusters on the ventral surface of the leaves near the midrib, sometimes lower and ventral side also. And the egg, the female lays about 2 to 25 eggs in a in her total life. Then the incubation period of this eggs is 2 to 5 days. So it is an average time duration which is required for the incubation of the eggs. So this is first stage, egg stage. Then it hatches into the larva. After 2 to 5 days of the incubation period, it hatches into the larva. Now this larva passes 5 to 6 instars. The larva is yellowish brown with reddish brown head and prothoracic shield, which measures about 25 millimeters long with series of black dots on its body. Next stage is pupal stage. Now this completely fully grown larva or caterpillar then pupates. Now this is a pupal stage. As we can see here in this figure, it pupates inside the stem in a small chamber. So it's a chamber which is prepared by itself. The caterpillar prepare for the development and protection of the pupal stage. And this takes, the larval period takes 28 to 35 days. So this for the completion of larval period, it takes 28 to 35 days, and after this duration it pupates. This pupation takes place for 8 to 15 days, means to complete formation of an adult inside the pupal stage, it requires 8 to 15 days, and after the pupal stage it becomes an adult moth. So this is an adult moth. Now this is how the complete life cycle goes on. So this total life cycle is completed within 30 to 40 days. So this complete life cycle requires 30 to 40 days. Now moving to the larval stage. Now young caterpillar has a black head and dirty white body with 4 long brown strips on its back. This larva bores into the stem and feeds on it. So the larva bores inside the stem and then complete feeding occurs inside the stem, and because of that dead heart is the result of completely feeding of the larva inside the stem portion. So this full grown caterpillar after 14 to 28 days become 25 millimeters in length. Then it pupates. Pupation takes place definitely inside the specially constructed chamber. Wherever it is residing, wherever it is inhabiting inside the inside the stem of the crop plant, there itself it prepares a chamber like structure, and then it resides there because it gets protection over there in the stem itself. And the pupal period lasts for 6 to 8 days. This pupa is reddish brown colored with 6 spines on the abdominal tip in a group of 3. So see, this is also one of the identification mark of the pupa. If you find this pupa, just check for the spines, brown colored spine, reddish brown colored spines, and which are present in the abdominal tip in a group of 3. So 3 groups of abdominal spines are found in the abdomen of the pupa. This is the identification mark of the pupa. Then next is the control measure. Now we have seen the whole life cycle, and now there is control measures. So here some of them are easiest methods, like we have to remove the dead heart. We should pull out the dead heart and we can use it as a fodder, or we can also bury it so that internally if there is larva or caterpillar is present or pupa is present inside that dead heart, that can be easily destroyed so that it will not spread itself. Then there is another way of control is to use the resistant varieties against jawar stem borer. This is also very good control measure. And lastly, if even we cannot avoid or we cannot control this jawar stem borer, then we have to go for the chemical applications, chemical pesticides like endrin or thymate. So few common pesticides we can use for every pest, like endrin, thymate, And also we can use 0.3% of phosphamidone or 0.05% of endosulfan can be also spread to control this pest. So this is one of the major pests of jawar stem borer, jawar called jawar stem borer, and the Chilopartilus is the scientific name of this pest. I hope you understand this topic. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Thank you for watching.